Captain Dandridge, I know you're heading back to Khe Sanh tomorrow and that conditions there are getting brutal. Hoss and I would like to be allowed to come with you. We can't leave the fight while the guys are under siege. And I want to know that my brother's okay. I know you could use us both. Sincerely, Dean Shepherd.
All right, men, we're approaching the airstrip. We can expect heavy fire. Charles has mortars and rockets positioned in the surrounding hills. They fire on the strip every time a plane approaches.
If you've never prayed before, Shep, this might be a good time.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Be advised, this plane will not stop when we land. When the cargo hatch opens and the plane slows down, we will offload out the back. Watch your footing and watch the man in front of you. When you hit the ground, run to your left toward the trenches. We will be under heavy fire. Good luck, and I'll see you on the ground.
Shit, what was that?
That's just the landing gear.
How's the Nom treating you guys today?
You boys seen Tammy Shepherd?
Nope. Don't know him. If he's smart, he's probably in his barracks laying chili. Man.
Well, he ain't too smart. It's been great talking to you guys. You stay cool.
Thank you. We got sappers inside the perimeter.
We're looking for his brother.
God damn it, I don't care if you're looking for Jesus Christ himself. Get on one of those guns.
Your brother and his squad are at an LP outside the perimeter. They're being overrun. They just called in an arc light on their own position.
Holy shit, we gotta get to them and pull them out before those bombs drop.
Negative. Those men are gonna have to ride this one out.
Sir, we're going for them. Maybe we can get them out of there before those B-52s come in.
Oh, hell! Okay, follow me!
Gotta push in there!
Shit.
We gotta get to that outpost! Well, I can probably put this first on the long list of stupid things I've done in Vietnam.
Thank you. 52's a- Ah! Shit!
Chuck, pick his ass up and let's get out of here.
We're racing against those B-52s. They'll be pounding the hell out of this whole area any minute. Let's go!
Hang in there, Jamie. We'll get you patched up in no time. Let's get out of here. Hoss and I caught our Freedom Bird out of Khe Sanh 2 days later. The North Vietnamese took a pounding that last night on the perimeter, and our flight was uneventful. Jamie and the rest of the guys had to stay on for a few more weeks. My brother spent most of his time in a medical bunker healing up. Westmoreland was supposed to arrive and pin some medals on the guys, but he was a no-show. Greaser and Smooth humped those hills for 2 more weeks. Like a lot of short-timers, they had visions of dying 1,000 different ways every day. Eventually, the rest of the guys got back to the world in one piece, but we were all changed. We had been forced to become adults in that little country in Southeast Asia that most people couldn't even find on a map. A lot of civilians don't understand what happened in the war. They don't want to understand. But soldiers understand. And even though I don't see the guys as much as I'd like to, I love them all like brothers. I know that no matter how much time and distance comes between us, these guys will always be there for me.